Hi and welcome to another Fishing Tales Tackle Talk. Today I'm looking at the Savage Gear SG4 Shore Game Fishing Rod. So when I bought this rod, I had a couple of ideas for its use. Obviously for lure fishing, but I was about to do some traveling and I thought I might be able to use it for a bit of light bait fishing. Let's see if this rod suits your needs right after this. Hi and welcome back. So let me tell you what I was thinking when I thought about buying this rod. For quite some time now I've been thinking I need a rod for surf fishing for bass. Now, as many of you know, bass will come in really close in the surf, normally the second or third wave out, but the best times normally when the bass do come in is when you've got a strong onshore wind straight in your face and you're trying to cast out. So then you need to up your game, go for heavier lures, often metals or lures that have got fairly big jig heads. And when you do that, you can't just be using a 20 to 30 gram rod. One of the other things I was thinking is that I wanted to take a rod to Bermuda with me. Now, the fish there are much bigger than they are here, and again, I expected to be using heavier lures. As it turned out, I didn't actually need heavier lures most of the time, but I also thought I could use it for a bit of bait fishing and maybe even a trip on a boat that I'd organised. I know this is not a boat rod and this is certainly not a travel rod. So with that in mind, I opted for this 10 to 60 gram SG4. Now let's take a quick look at the tech specs on this. So the blank is made from 30 ton Japanese toray carbon. I'm not going to get into the argument of the merits of different types of carbon. Let's just say toray are probably one of the better Japanese carbon manufacturers, so you know that this is going to be a good quality weave on this blank. So the blank is furnished with sea guide stainless steel guides and they're fitted with sin rings. Now a sin ring isn't something you get from your missus every time you misbehave. It's actually silicon nitride, which is the material the rings are made from, which is very smooth, very hard wearing, and that makes it ideal when you're using braid. So those of you who've seen Fishing Tales tackle reviews before know that we don't just give the rod a quick wiggle or the reel a quick spin. We get it out there, we absolutely thrash it, and then we tell you the good points and the bad points. So this is my thoughts on this rod. And it is a good job that I did review this rod properly, because when I first got it I didn't actually like it. Now that had very little to do with the rod and the actual setup I had. Once I got a feel for the rod, I was easily able to bang out 40 to 50 gram metal leads straight into an onshore wind with no problem whatsoever. Even when I went to Bermuda and I was casting big surface poppers well in excess of 60 grams, I never felt for 1 minute that the blank was going to let me down or fold on me. It just soaked up the cast, released beautifully and loaded up extremely well, so the casts were nice and smooth. Now the other thing I use a lot of is surface lures, so I need to work those lures, and having a fast action rod like this is absolutely perfect. I cannot fault it for its action, the way it loads up and the way it releases. Really, really enjoyed fishing with this rod once I'd sorted my issues out with it. So the lower section of this rod is covered in a hard wearing EVA. It's also the top of the locking handle. Now let's talk about the reel seat. It's called an Alien Lockdown reel seat. It's a two-way locking mechanism. You have this rather large EVA covered lock and then you have a smaller one. But you know that once those two are locked into place, your reel is not going to go anywhere, and that's really important if you're fighting a big fish or you're casting for hours and hours. So that's one of the things that I do really like about this whole setup. So just above the locking handle is a hook retaining clip. Now I personally don't like hook retaining clips, because if you're using a metal lure and you put it in next to it, there is chance that this could bang up and down against the blank and damage the blank. So let's talk about the aesthetics of this rod. Now this is where I think it lets itself down a little bit. I don't like this matte green covering that the blank has from tip to toe. I prefer a rod with a little bit more class. To me, this almost seems like it's a poor cousin. Now I know this colour will certainly have favour amongst the freshwater anglers, but I don't want to put a rod down and then have someone stand on it and it's be broken. You might think that's a bit ridiculous, but how many times have people come along when you're just unhooked a fish and go, oh, what have you caught? They don't see the rod, they stand on it, it becomes damaged. When it becomes damaged, replacing these rings with the whipping and the matte finish is going to be extremely difficult. So I know how well this rod works for heavy lures like poppers, jig heads, even metal jigs. What I'm not going to say is how great it is on soft plastics. Apart from fish black minnow and a Savage Gear sand eel, I rarely use soft plastics. But what I do know is for other uses, this rod really has come into its own. Whilst I was in Bermuda, I did quite a bit of bait fishing from the shore as well as lure fishing. It was able to handle, I guess, 2 ounces of lead without any problem, bit of bait. And then some of the fish were hitting me so hard, and I had to really hold on, let the drag of the reel do the work, and let the rod soak up the power lunges from these fish. It handled it really, really well. But I also had the opportunity to take it on a small boat. Now this isn't a boat rod, it's 9 foot long. I know people are using 9 foot long boat rods, but this is not designed as a boat rod, but I did use it and I did absolutely put it through its paces. As you can see here, sometimes the rod tip was right in the water, but never did I ever think the rod was going to break or it didn't have the backbone to tame some of these fish. Let's talk about the important factor, the price. I paid £109 for this rod. I'm sure if you shop around, you can get it a little bit cheaper. But what I will say is I think even at £109, you're getting a very good value for money. You're getting a 30-ton Torre carbon blank that fishes really well. Good quality stainless steel guides, good quality rings, and what I think is probably one of the better reel seats that you can put on a rod at the moment. So, does this rod get my recommendation? Yes. But this is not the rod that I would use as my everyday lure rod. It's a little bit too heavy for that. I prefer to do most of my lure work at short range with lighter lures, so a 10 to 30 gram rod is my go-to rod. But when I'm out trying to get something out into the surf, heavier metals, or I'm using big jerk baits for pike, this is my go-to rod. But it's not only a lure rod. It can be used as a light bait rod, as I have done. I even took it on the boat, as you've seen earlier. So as an all-round medium duty rod, it's a fantastic piece of kit. I love it. I thoroughly recommend it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. I will get back to you. And if you want to see any other reviews, let me know what you want to see and I will try and get the equipment, whether I have to buy it, borrow it, I may even have it already, and I'm happy to do a review of it for you. Please do a favour for me, subscribe, like, and follow the channel. Thank you very much.